Brahma is every human being. He is described as emerging from a lotus. This is a metaphor for a child emerging out of a mother's womb. This is also a metaphor for the gradual unfolding of the imagination. Birth is not a choice, and survival is a struggle, a violent struggle plagued by fears of scarcity and predation. This is true for plants, animals, and humans, but only humans can reflect on those fears and resent it and seek liberation from it. Imagination makes Brahma think of scarcity in the midst of abundance, war in times of peace. He assumes he has no choice in the matter. Like Markandeya, he can imagine Shiva, but unlike Markandeya, he does not have faith in Shiva. He therefore does not discover Atma and finds himself alone and helpless before nature. Who is the cause of this mystery? He wonders, is nature the villain? Who came first, the victim or the villain? Nature or humanity? Prakriti or Brahma? Objectively speaking, nature came first. Nature is the parent. Humanity is the child. Subjectively speaking, however, imagination caused the rupture between humanity and nature. Imagination forced Purusha to visualize itself as distinct from Prakriti. That makes nature the child. Humanity then is the parent. Thus, Prakriti is both parent and child of Brahma. He depends on her for his survival. But she is not dependable. She is a cruel mother and a disobedient daughter. He feels ignored and abandoned and helpless and anxious. He blames her for his misery. In fear, he allows his mind to be corrupted. Brahma's expectations of Prakriti are imaginary. Nature does not love him or hate him. Nature has no favorites. All creatures are equal in Prakriti's eyes because Brahma can imagine. He imagines himself to be special and so expects to be treated different by nature. This is because of